All right, welcome back. So here's that same circuit from the previous video where we're actually putting some values in and we're going to calculate these numbers so that we understand what's going on with our control device. As mentioned before, VCC, in this case here, 15 volts. There's our earth reference point. So we're going to drop all that pressure across this circuit. Collector, emitter resistor, and biasing resistors. We're going to select a beta of 100. I put DC down here for a couple of reasons. One, for DC, for direct current, we use capital letters like that, all right? And for, so I would say that is a quiescent current. This is, again, a DC current. Same thing here, okay? Capital letters. We'll see later when we actually bring a signal in because someone wants to play with the tap that we'll use small letters for the values of that pressure and flow. Okay, so let's go back through remembering that we had a couple of fundamental formulas. We had Ohm's law, correct? Pressure equals flow times pushback. And the other one is gain, which is beta. Greek letter B, which is I collector divided by I base. All right, those two. We got it all. So let's go through this. We said before that to pick off a value here, we would use VCC times R2 over R1 plus R2. So that would be essentially 25.3K, correct? Let's just do it like this, 25,300. So K is 1,000, it's a multiplier by 1,000. And we have R2, which is 3,300. And we're multiplying that by 15. So just do the math in your head or with your calculator, and you should come up to, see if you get the same number I do. I'm gonna do it in my head. Okay, I get something like that. Looks reasonable. Okay, so that is the value of VB. Good, we got this point set up. We said that across this construction that we call an NPN, and as electrical types, you have to know your symbols. You have to understand when an arrow is pointing in a certain direction, what it means. You have to understand what the polarity is, the plus and minuses, the direction of flow. You have to understand it in the business, okay? So we do recall that the voltage drop across this particular junction or diode, silicon diode, is 0.7 volts. That being the case, if we have VB sitting here at 1.96 volts, then what would this be? VE would be 1.96 minus 0.7, and that would be equal to, correct? 1.26 volts. I think that's reasonable. Okay, that's done. All right, if we know the value of VE here, and we have a resistor there, then let's plug that number in to calculate IE. So IE will be 1.26 volts divided by, watch your symbols. I have some students who have used ohms for volts and such, and that's, again, totally incorrect, totally incorrect. So 1.26, in this case here, a nice easy number, 1,000 ohms, all right? That's going to be equal to, anybody? 12.6 1,000ths, small m, volts, all right, millivolts. Again, I'm using top of my head, that looks to be reasonable. Yeah, all right. Sorry. Back to, nobody corrected me on this. What's going on with you guys? So, this is not volts. This is not volts. This is Ohm's law, which is voltage divided by ohms equals milliamps. Thank you for correcting me over there. Okay, so this is current, 1.26 milliamps we're talking about. And there's another thing that I'd like to explain, is that if you come up with amps through a small little teeny device like this, you're totally out of the ballpark. So look at the magnitude of the numbers as well. Let's not get ridiculous. This is not Niagara Falls driving it. This is not electric trains being run by these devices. These are very small signal control devices. So let's make sure that our units are appropriate. Okay, so we've got IE, we've got that. We said, why don't we use the approximation that IC equals IE, and therefore IC should be equal to 1.26 milliamps as well. What about IB? Well, IB is equal to, so let's rearrange this. IB is equal to IC divided by beta. So we have IC. If we divide that by 100, it would be something like this. One, two, I'm going over too many. So one, two, so that would be 0.0126, again, milliamps, or it's equal to 12.6. Anybody? Thank you, microamps, okay. That's why we say that because this is so small compared to this, that we can make the approximation that IC and IE is the same. So we've got this one, we've got this one, we've got this one, which only leaves VC. And what we notice is we're going to drop amount of pressure, a certain amount of pressure across this resistor. So VC is going to be, at the collector, is going to be the overall push minus, in this case here, what are you dropping across here? Well, it's IC times RC. So 15 volts minus 1.26 times 10 to the minus 3 amperes, or 1.26 milliamps, times 5 times 10 to the 3, or 5,000 ohms. And so let's do the math. We have 15 minus 0.36.3. So that's 15 volts minus that is equal to 8.7 volts. I had an instructor used to say at the end of his lectures, QED, quo est demonstrum is the Latin, but I used to interpret it as quite easily done.